We just said that was Austin's, though.
Oh, okay. Then,
Austin's the fittest man in the world.
Yeah.
Austin,
yeah.
Maybe he's fit. Maybe he's an elite actor.
He's pretty fit, though. I would go with, 80.
80.
Yeah, we'll put an 8 there.
What a Price is Right, sir.
I know.
81.
81. Nice. 81. No. 81.1. Hannah, we'll go back to you. What do you want?
79.9. Now I'm playing.
Hannah is going to go 91. Who didn't we get? Is that 6 of them? Who didn't give me a value?
I don't.
Oh, yeah, but you did, but you said 81.1. You are currently out of the running, Austin. Sorry, you're not going to be on the prices.
You right. are the weakest link.
You are the weakest link. Our winner is Hannah, 91.
Jesus.
95 mls per, I think 93, 95 mls per kg per minute. Now, tell me what athlete.
Ultra marathon
runner.
Wait, what sport or what human?
What sport, what athlete, what sport? Basketball.
Triathlon.
Decathlon. Golf.
Yeah. Yes. You're my favorite student in this class.
You got it all.
You are. Yeah. Woo! Raise the roof for him. Cross country skiing. Now tell me why, Anna.
Very hard.
And why is it very hard?
Chess is very hard.
Why? What does cross country? What are you using?
Ease. Whole body,
arms and legs are cranking, so you're using a higher percentage of muscle mass because you're using arms and legs. So what did you say? Don't use a lot of their arms, do they? Basketball isn't an aerobic sport. It's more of an anaerobic sport, sprinting up and down. But they do use their more of their arms. What did you say?
Triathlon,
maybe. When you're swimming, but then typically you're using more of your arms and your legs than swimming, I think. I don't know how that works. What did you say?
Decathlon.
Yeah, sure. That's maybe if they're running the 800 meters or the 1600 meters, but again, they're only using their legs in that one, so that's not even right. What did you say? So is that correct? What are they using? Just their legs. Now, can you get a high VO2 in a cyclist? Who has a high VO2? Anybody know what Armstrong's is?
He's like 76, right?
85. So that's not bad for just using your legs. Yeah, so he was recorded at 85 at UT Austin in Ed Coyle's lab. They did a study on him. It's interesting, it was an anonymous study about an elite cyclist that is from Austin, Texas. That got 85 miles per hour. You narrow it down pretty quickly about who the anonymous cyclist is. So, 93-95, Scandinavian cross-country skiers. Why? They probably got good genetics. They probably grew up, they're very efficient in cross-country skiing because they've been doing it their whole life. And so, they're well-trained. And so, they come and do that. And so, because they're using a lot of their muscle mass to do that exercise. I don't know who the person was. Let's call him Bjorn. I think we'll probably be getting through this week. Yeah, exactly. Probably.
How about testing your team has a better deal with a full body?
So the question, that's a great question. Noah brings the question is what's the best way to test VO2? You didn't think Bjorn was a good answer? I thought it was perfect. It's like Jim.
It was a good one.
Yeah.
Or Bob. Perfect Nordic name.
Yeah. So, what's the best way to test aerobic fitness? If you were a cyclist, Noah, what would you want to test on?
Cycle.
If you were a cross-country skier, what would you want to test on? Skiing. Can you test on? Can we even test that?
Yes.
Yes, we can. Elliptical. So Tosh, the Orthopedic Specialty Hospital in Salt Lake City, Utah, has a treadmill that is exceptionally wide and exceptionally long that you can cross-country ski on. You can speed skate on it and do VO2 max testing, cross-country skiing, and speed skating.
It's a treadmill?
It's a treadmill.
What do you do with your arms, though?
The same thing you would do.
Same thing you do with your arms there. Yeah. You can get treadmills and run horses on them.
What about an elliptical?
So, but is that what they train? Is it elliptical training? Or do you want to put them on roller skis and have them do roller skiing like they train?
Elliptical is still like a cyclical motion.
So it would be specific to their activity. Now, is Lance Armstrong going to give you a high VO2 on a treadmill?
No.
Probably because he's an elite athlete and he has good genetics. So his VO2 on a treadmill is probably going to be relatively high. But it's probably going to be higher on his sport-specific device. Okay. So if you are an elite aerobic athlete, you're probably going to do well on, like, would these cross-country skiers do well on a treadmill test? Yeah, they're going to be elite athletes. So they may be in the 80s, which would be amazing. But if you wanted to find out where their best is, what their sport specific is at, okay? Yeah. And so, but again, not the best predictor of endurance performance. So I'll show you at some point the Tour de France, where Lance Armstrong is going up Alpe d'Huez, which is the big mountain climb that they have. And he's looking back at his main competitor. His name is Jan Ulrich. Jan Ulrich is just as gifted, just as doped as Lance Armstrong is. So, but Lance Armstrong can probably push through more pain than Jan Ulrich can. So you can have somebody that maybe has a lower VO2 and can push through psychologically some difficult situations compared to a prima donna like Noah that is, he crushes under the pressure because, you know, he's wearing the shirt because of, what was the comment that you said there?
It's trendy.
It's trendy. That's a guy that you can crush in a mountain climb. He's a guy that's trim, right? We're just throwing that out there. So Lance Armstrong, it's called the look. Lance Armstrong is ahead of Jan Ulrich as they're climbing up there. They're both on their bikes, on their seats. Lance Armstrong looks over his left shoulder and sees Lance Armstrong, or Jan Ulrich, is blown. Can't do it. And he looks at him, stares at him for a long time, and then he jumps off his bike and starts pounding up the thing, and Jan Ulrich does this. It's over. It's Lance Armstrong won the Tour de France right there. Drove a spike through Jan Ulrich. Okay? All right. We're going to now stay and watch biathlon, Wendy. So I don't care what time it is because you guys said.
You told me to let you know.
No, Wendy. Does anybody have class right after this? No. We're now currently watching biathlon. And the reason is because you guys made fun of shooting.
You guys.
Austin, you were no, you were in there too.
Okay. Slingshots on ice skates, let's see it.
Slingshots on ice skates.
Yeah.
I give you that. I wouldn't watch
fire, that. Let's go to firing guns under pressure.
That finger skater is a gun.
Yeah.
Man, I like snowboarding.
So first of all,
or gym gymnastics and swords.
Something went
anybody get to see Shaun White snowboard?
No.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Sword.
He bit the dust on his second run, man. I mean, he crashed.
Who did?
So
he
why
scored a
55
on his second run.
What's up with that?
He scored like a 98-something, though, in the qualifiers.
What was his final run?
Yeah, 97-something.
I think they're only allowing us to watch videos of like things that are
that,
cool.
That,
do they block us here?
That Japanese dude, though, was...
You're
was like neck and neck with him.
We'll watch it. So I don't know why it's not letting us do it.
And Chloe Kim's pretty bad to the bone, man.
We will watch it next time. We're going to watch biathlon. And you guys better do your homework and watch biathlon. So I don't want to hear any more talk about how crappy biathlon.